We're talking digital money. Seriously? Too soon. We're talking about Bitcoin. Bitcoin comes from the word bit. Bit is short for binary digit, which is actually the smallest unit of data on a computer. Then it comes from the word coin, which is currency. So Bitcoin. Think of it as the currency of the internet. Bitcoin has been around since 2008. It was actually around the time of the financial collapse, and an anonymous programmer, or programmers, by the name of Satoshi Nakamoto, released a document explaining how Bitcoin, a new currency online, would be developed. Okay, but before we get any further, let's explain how Bitcoin works. First is the Bitcoin itself, the digital cryptocurrency. The second is the Bitcoin miner, the programmers or the individuals who are extracting Bitcoin from the internet and mining it. And the third concept is blockchain. There's a set number of Bitcoins out there. In order to extract Bitcoin, to mine Bitcoin, you have to solve math problems called hash algorithms. Hash algorithms are actually found on the internet broadly, not just for Bitcoin. Once they solve a hash algorithm using computing power, the Bitcoin gets extracted, it's given to the miner, and then the rest of the Bitcoin community has to take a look at that coin and verify that yes, that Bitcoin was mined appropriately. Four other miners work in analyzing and verifying Bitcoin. They are also rewarded with newly minted Bitcoin. Now you have a Bitcoin. Now you go ahead and you want to use your digital currency. You purchase a product with someone using Bitcoin. The Bitcoin will carry the history that it was made by you, then given to the seller. Now the seller turns around and buys more product with Bitcoin. Now the Bitcoin carries the history that it was made by you, given to a seller, then given to a manufacturer. And on it goes. But every person is actually just an anonymous number. It's not tracking specifically that you owned it, it's just tracking that an individual owned it. For this historical record on Bitcoin is called the blockchain. Here are a few Bitcoin benefits. First is that there is no middleman. Payment fees, transaction fees, currency conversion fees. But with Bitcoin, none of that is there. Two, only a certain amount of Bitcoin that can be mined. In fact, it is capped at 21 million Bitcoins. It is expected that we will only mine all the Bitcoins in 2140. Bitcoin also removes the double spend problem because of the blockchain. But there's also some big negatives about Bitcoin. The first being it fluctuates very, very highly. A huge percentage of Bitcoin is reserved for the founder or founders of Bitcoin. That definitely creates a super elite. The third con for Bitcoin is what most people fear, is that it'll be used for the black market. One thing to remember though is that this is just the beginning of cryptocurrencies, and that we have a lot to learn from cryptocurrencies, of transactions that move freely across borders, of blockchain, of creating a historical ledger for all currencies and removing the double spend. Those are things that Bitcoin has taught us. Thank you so much for watching. Before we wrap up, I would love it if you could comment down below. Use this website that I've also linked in the description and search what the current value of Bitcoin is the day you watch this video. And we're gonna see how much the value of Bitcoin is really fluctuating. Also, subscribe, help share this video, and spread some digital literacy.